Consider a period when the Earth was an untamed wilderness, with immense seas serving as impenetrable barriers between continents. Despite all odds, our ancient ancestors risked their journey into these uncharted seas. Who were these daring explorers, and what transportation did they use to embark on such risky voyages? This video dives into the history of sailing, going back to the very first voyages of our earliest ancestors. The narrative of early sailing starts with Indonesia's intriguing islands, particularly Java and Flores. These islands contained archaeological evidence indicating that Homo erectus, our early human predecessors, may have been among the first to sail the oceans. But how did these early human ancestors accomplish such an amazing feat like reaching Indonesia's smaller islands? Java and Flores are isolated from the Asian continent by deep marine seas. Interestingly, there are archaeological discoveries on these islands that include stone tools going back over a million years, predating the appearance of Homo sapiens. These artifacts indicate that Homo erectus or other early hominins may have crossed the oceans to reach these islands using boats. The first important hint of their choice of transportation comes from the finding of stone tools on Flores that date back roughly 800,000 years. These artifacts are thought to have been used by Homo florentiensis, a small hominid species found on the island. The discovery of these tools suggests that early people may have traversed the oceans to reach Flores, which has never been linked to the mainland by a land bridge. Homo erectus bones going back over a million years have also been discovered in Java, providing more proof of their travels via crude boats or rafts. But these early people would have faced major problems traversing the seas to get to these islands. The subject of what kind of boats these early sailors utilized is a source of heated discussion and fascination. Unfortunately, organic materials such as wood and reeds seldom withstand the passage of time, leaving no clear proof of these ancient vessels. However, we can build conclusions from subsequent historical instances and anthropological research. Early people would have employed easily accessible materials like wood, bamboo, and reeds. These materials are buoyant and can be formed into basic rafts or boats. Construction of these watercrafts would have required a rudimentary grasp of buoyancy and stability, as well as a capacity to mold materials into a practical form. One type of watercraft is the dugout canoe, which is constructed by hollowing out a log. The style of boat has been utilized by many civilizations across the globe and is one of the most basic and practical types of watercraft. Another option could have been to build a raft by tying together logs or bamboo poles. Rafts are sturdy and capable of carrying huge loads, making them ideal for transporting people and cargo across water. The oldest form of waterborne vessels known to humans must have been made of naturally buoyant materials, such as reed or bamboo rafts. These primitive vessels can be seen represented in ancient petroglyphs and have been utilized by many civilizations across the world. The simplicity and efficiency of their design imply that our ancestors, with their knowledge in primitive tools, may have employed similar techniques to what we see in some cultures today. For thousands of years, for example, the Aymara people of South America's Lake Titicaca have utilized reed canoes. These vessels are constructed by bundling reeds and molding them into boat-like shapes. The reeds are naturally buoyant, resulting in a sturdy and lightweight canoe that is simple to navigate. Another sturdy, flexible, and buoyant material, excellent for building rafts, is bamboo. The Moken people of Southeast Asia have long utilized bamboo rafts for fishing and transportation. These rafts are constructed by connecting bamboo poles together and are readily mended or replaced if broken. The thing that stands out the most from these primitive vessels is how similar boats continue to be used in various regions of the globe today. The reed boats of Lake Titicaca in South America and the bamboo rafts of Southeast Asia show how all technology is still relevant today. Their usage in current times implies that our forefathers may have used similar ways to traverse the seas and discover new territories. If you find the secrets of our primitive history as interesting as we do, then subscribe to our channel and dive further into the history of human creativity and discovery. So far, we have made some conjectures as to what materials our ancestors could have used to travel the seas, but what evidence is there that proves their maritime capabilities? There is a very old dugout boat, actually the earliest known watercraft, built from a single Scots pine timber that helped reveal important details about our ancient predecessors' nautical ability. It was unearthed in the Netherlands, and until now, it is the oldest known boat made from a basic but successful design that uses the hollowed-out wood for buoyancy and stability. Dating back to 8040 and 7510 BC, the Pessi canoe demonstrates a great degree of expertise and material knowledge, reflecting the artistry needed to make such a vessel. The canoe is around 3 meters long and 40 centimeters broad, making it ideal for one or two persons. The finding of this ancient boat indicates that early people had the skills and knowledge required to build boats and traverse rivers. Let's fast forward a bit. In 1947, a man named Thord Heyerdahl and his team floated a balsa wood raft from South America to the Polynesian Islands, demonstrated that ancient people might have made comparable expeditions using basic but efficient watercraft. This trip is known as the Kon-Tiki Expedition and demonstrated the viability of rudimentary rafts for oceanic crossings. Heyerdahl's trip was motivated by the idea that ancient South Americans may have reached Polynesia using rudimentary rafts. The Kon-Tiki raft was built using traditional materials and techniques, including balsa wood planks tied together and a basic sail. The expedition lasted 101 days and covered 4,300 miles, showing that even rudimentary vessels could travel large distances over the ocean. The Kon-Tiki expedition's accomplishment gave persuasive evidence that early people were capable of exploring and settling distant islands using comparable tactics and minimal technology. Now let's take a look back at the discovery of stone tools on Indonesian islands. Tools that provoked a debate. How did early people get there? Was it via rudimentary sailing? Or was there a land bridge that connected these islands to the mainland? The lack of boats from the archaeological record adds to the enigma, allowing us to continue wondering about our predecessors' inventiveness and adaptability. The idea that we have discussed is that early people crossed the seas in crude boats to reach these islands, according to probable evidence from the Kon-Tiki voyage and the Pessi canoe finding. However, another idea is that there was a land bridge that linked the islands to the mainland, enabling early people to walk or wade over. This notion is reinforced by the fact that sea levels were much lower during the Pleistocene period, owing to widespread glaciation. Lower sea levels would have exposed more land, perhaps resulting in land bridges connecting islands to the mainland. But the occurrence of deep oceanic trenches between the islands and the mainland makes this explanation less plausible. The depths of these trenches show that, even with lower sea levels, early people would have had to traverse large areas of open ocean. One thing is for sure, whether our ancestors employed rudimentary boats or walked over land bridges, their ability to explore and colonize new territories illustrates their inventiveness and persistence. What are your thoughts? Is it possible that our primitive lineage was more evolved than we know, or is there another explanation? Our videos dive into the amazing lives of our ancestors, so make sure to check them out.